The Stedelijk Museum is an international institution in Amsterdam dedicated to modern and contemporary art and design. It's located at the Museumplein, close to the Van Gogh Museum, the Rijksmuseum and the Concertgebouw. The Stedelijk, founded in 1874, moved into the museum's own building in 1895. The neo-Renaissance style museum building was designed by the Dutch architect Adrian Willem Weisman. In 2012, after 8 years of work, the new Stedelijk futuristic wing designed by Bentham Crowell Architects opened. The new wing, sometimes referred to as the bathtub, consists of a large glassed entrance with galleries for temporary exhibition both on the upper level and in the basement. It also houses a museum shop, restaurant and a library, as well as an auditorium. Today, Stedelijk has one of the richest collections of modern and contemporary art and design in the world, with more than 90,000 objects from the early 20th century. With the expansion, the highlights of the collection are on display in a series of never-ending presentations, permanent and special exhibition of both art and design. Here we are at the Stedelijk in Amsterdam to meet with Ingeborg de Roude, who is the curator for industrial design. Tell me a little bit about the background.
And in 1934, the design department started. And from that moment on, we collect industrial design, applied art, so more the unique pieces, and graphic design. And now we have about 60,000 pieces in our collection of design.
When it comes to collecting, do you have a clear strategy, or do you build as you go?
Well, from the beginning, our design collection is focused on the interior, so we don't have cars and bicycles, etc. So that was our focus point from the beginning. And what we always try to do is that we collect not only individual pieces, but pieces from an oeuvre of a designer or an artist. So we really try to follow people and collect interesting pieces from their whole career, in fact. So that is very important for us. And in the design department, I think it's one of the most important things is that it always has to do with some novelty, a development in design.
Does that also apply to graphic design?
Well, that we follow the career of a designer, of course, but not so that it should be for the interior, because we have a lot of posters. That's about more than 20,000 pieces.
When it comes to Holland, you have quite a few designers here that are world known. How come?
Well, I think a few things came together in the 90s. There was a very liberal design culture in the Netherlands, because we had government departments that gave commissions to designers, and they were very good commissioners, in fact. In the 90s, this came together, and they had a lot of freedom also, because there were grants in the Netherlands they could get from the government, so they could develop themselves in a relative freedom, in fact.
What roles do the school play in this?
The academies have a very important function, I think. We have very good academies, arts, and of course the Design Academy in Eindhoven, but also the art academies in The Hague and Amsterdam and Utrecht and Arnhem. They have all design departments. Important designers work there as teachers. So the students learn it from very good designers, in fact.
The Stedelijk plays a big role in the development of the design world, as I understand.
I hope so.
Where will you go from now?
Well, of course, we have already plans for the future. And of course we will have several presentations of contemporary design. We are preparing for next year a smaller presentation about social design. And there will be a graphic design exhibition about a French designer, Philippe Appellois. And of course we will take a look at how we're going to collect all kind of new developments, because there's so much going on, you know, in open design, social design, designers doing more process-like things than real products. Yeah. So we're going to talk about how we can show it in the museum and how we can collect it.
If you were to give a young person that wants to become a curator an advice, what would that be?
Don't do what everybody else does, but find your own subjects and write about it. You know, there are so many blogs now, so make yourself known to the world and what you're interested in.